What's going on, guys? I'm Eli Bonanno, and today I'm going to be teaching you a corkswing chord. Before we get started, I haven't done YouTube in a long, long time, but I want to do it every day and make new tutorials every day. So comment if you want to see new tutorials and what tutorials you would like to see. Now, let's get straight into it. So, the first thing you want to do when learning a corkswing chord is to be comfortable landing on one leg. That would be your left leg, which is your takeoff leg. So after you can do that really well and really easily, now it's time to start swinging for corkswing chord. So it's important to be at kind of an angle whenever you go into the second cork, or else you can drift if you land too much this way and lean more to your right, or you can gainer if you take off too early. So focus on getting that timing perfectly before you actually attempt it, because you can actually get really hurt. If you don't know what a corkswing cork is, here's what one looks like. Notice how I drifted really far back whenever I did that one. That's because I took off a little bit too late. So the importance of taking off at the right time is massive. So make sure you're getting that timing right on. Another thing I'd like to talk about is actually whenever you go into your corkswing cork, it's a lot different than going into a normal cork. So with corkswing cork, you really want to do a J step rather than an L step. If you've been doing an L step for your normal corks, I'd suggest to change it up, because you can actually drift and cause yourself to hurt yourself. So what a J-step really is kind of going at a curve. So start here, and then curve it up. That's a J-step. Now there's a lot of progressions that you can do before you actually do corkswing cork, such as corkswing through gainer, corkswing through kick the moon. There's tons of different progressions you can do. Here, I'll demonstrate. So that was cork cheek gainer. You can really do anything else that you can really swing above your head, and that'll help whenever you try and attempt a corkswing cork for the first time. You'll be used to kind of getting over the fear of swinging and flipping over again, so I'd say it's pretty helpful. Another thing to focus on is that your second cork should be the same as your first cork. You're at an angle, you swing with your leg straight and over to your shoulder, and then just land on that leg and do the same thing you did with your first cork. You don't want to like whip your twist or, you know, bend your leg, because that'll just take away from the power, and later on you can actually just combo it again and do another cork after. So if you really just drill, you know, doing the cork over and over and over again the same way, each cork the same way, it'll be much easier to, you know, combo and do tons of other stuff with it. So make sure your second cork is the same as your first one. Now, that's pretty much all you need to know for the corkswing chord. The reason I'm cutting this video off so quickly is because I actually have an in-depth tutorial on the chord. So that'll teach you about blocking and tons of other stuff. How to land your corks, how to set. It's really, really helpful. So I recommend checking it out. It helped tons of people from my Instagram. By the way, if you want to check out my Instagram, it's right here. And I really post a lot on that, so I think you'd be happy. Also, I'd like to say that it is so hot outside, and that's why I'm sweating all over the place. I'm going to do one more corkswing cork for you, and then you'll have an example. So here we go. Alright, well, I hope you guys all enjoyed my video, and be ready to see other videos. So thank you guys so much for watching. I'll see you guys in the next video. Peace out.